Today, I will introduce a new reference generation technology called Bindweave. Previous reference generation models could only generate relatively simple actions. Complex interactive forms of action could not be generated. Therefore, this model incorporates a new architecture called the MLLM DiT architecture. Next, let's look at some basic examples. Notice how nimble and dynamic the movements of these characters are. They are not as rigid as those generated by traditional vase or other models, for instance. In multi-person examples, there are videos with very strong interactions. It's not just two characters simply standing together. There is a very natural interaction between the characters. So, what exactly is the MLLM DiT architecture? It sounds quite mysterious. Let's look at the architectural diagram in its paper. This diagram clearly illustrates the architecture. The architecture is actually composed of two main parts. One is QW2.5VL, and the second is our traditional diffusion model. If you look, both our prompts and our images undergo a dual process. For example, our reference image first undergoes processing by the QWMVL visual model. Similarly, the prompt is also processed by the QWM model. For the subsequent steps, the prompt will be text encoded using our T5 encoder, and our image will also be encoded using our VAE. Therefore, with the assistance of QWMVL, the structure generated by the entire model provides a strengthening effect on both the subject and the prompt. This allows the generation quality to become higher. Currently, Qijai's One Video extension already supports this model. We can also download the corresponding FP8 model from Qijai's Hugging Face repository. Also, I have built the workflow on RunningHub. You can access this platform through runninghub.ai. In the ComfyUI domain, RunningHub is an excellent online working platform because whenever new technologies and new models emerge, it follows up immediately. You can register for RunningHub using the invitation link in my video description. This way, you can receive 1,000 free credits. Additionally, you will also receive 100 bonus credits every day you log into RunningHub. This allows you to try out your own workflows. Let's first look at the main model loading. The main model I have loaded here is the Bindweave FP8M model. Please note, this model is based on WAN2.1. Furthermore, I have enabled block swapping here. The value for block swapping in the official workflow should be 48. I have currently changed it to 45. Also, we have an acceleration LoRa here. We are using an IV LoRa image to video LoRa, which is also provided by Qijai. You can download this LoRa using the provided address. Next are our text encoder and our VAE. Below that is the section for our reference image. Pay attention for this reference image. I have loaded a picture of a beautiful woman. The resolution we have set here is 960x544, and the frame count is 81 frames. Therefore, we can scale it now. Note that I have skipped a node here. This node is a remove background node. If your background is relatively complex, and we only need the character information, you can enable this node, meaning we mask out the character. This will be more accurate. Since my background here is relatively simple, I have not performed the background removal operation. Now, let's look at the most crucial part of this workflow. Ultimately, we will definitely generate an image embed which will be used during sampling. How is this image embed generated? It mainly uses this node called WAN_VideoAddBindweaveEmbed. This node is actually the most important node for implementing the Bindweave model. Here, it uses a traditional embed. Then, it involves a reference latent, and also our reference mask. Very importantly, there is a QW embedded vector here. The embed comes from our traditional one video image to video encode node. The focus here is on two inputs. One is the VAE, and the other is the clip embed. We generally refer to this clip embed as visual encoding. It takes the visual model through our visual encoding node to encode our reference image, which produces an output. We have used this model more than once, haven't we? Next, to look at how the reference latent is obtained here. We use the VA and our reference image. So all you need to do is connect the VA and connect our reference image, and we perform a VAE coding. Moving further down, we need a mask. Pay attention, this mask is actually generated here. Below that is the QWNVL embed. How is this obtained here? We will use a Qwen 2.5VL model. First, we connect our reference image to the image input. Then, there is a prompt here. A beautiful woman in a garden is smelling the flowers. Then, here, we use a new encoder. However, the model used by this encoder is Qwen-VL. Therefore, we will load the Qwen-VL7B model. You can consider this encoding process to be the same as our text encoding process, except that the encoders are different. By connecting our prompt and encoding it, we get a Qw-embedded vector. This is the one we just used. After encoding, we obtain the final embedded vector for the image. It contains both the image portion encoded by our traditional VAE and the portion encoded by our Qw-VL. During sampling, we utilize our traditional T5 encoder to encode the prompt and obtain the text embedded. Up to this point, you will notice that the four types of encoding we mentioned have all appeared. Qw encoding for the image and text encoding, VAE encoding for the image, and finally, our T5 encoder's text encoding for the prompt. Putting these four encodings into the sampler significantly enhances the generation result. Take a look, I am currently using four steps for sampling. Let's observe the generated result. Look at the character consistency, the coherence of the movement, and the overall complexity of the action, which is quite high. Of course, with a single character, the effect may not be particularly obvious. We can make the action more complex. Let's look at the second workflow. Here, we used our Qwen-VL model. Then, I used my previous prompt generator to generate a JSON formatted prompt. Let's look at the resulting generation. Since the scene I wanted to generate was this beautiful woman walking on the beach, if you look, the quality is very high, right? Regardless of the action or the overall scene, relatively speaking, the videos generated by Vase are more rigid, of course, no matter what. This is still based on an image. With two images, we can achieve relatively good interaction. Let's look at this example. Now, there are two images. Since the background is relatively simple, I also don't need background removal. I am still skipping this step because the image resolution is actually misaligned with the resolution we set. Therefore, after we resize it, you will find that we have set a mask because I used the pad method to adjust its resolution to 16:9. So it will first scale it down and then pad both sides. The truly effective area is still this middle section. So this is the mask. This is a picture of a man. I will also get a mask like this and an image like this. The subsequent steps are essentially the same. However, my prompt is still written quite complexly. Take a look. It says the video shows two people sitting together and they are looking at a laptop. The man is sitting on the left and the woman is sitting next to him. Her hand is embracing his shoulder. This implies that they have a very intimate relationship. Therefore, this action is actually quite complex. Let's look at the generated result. First, you should note that when there are two characters, the consistency is indeed reduced. This is practically a common issue with previous 1.2.1 models. With a single image, character consistency is very strong. However, with multiple characters, character consistency cannot be guaranteed. Of course, that is not the main point. The main point is the interactive action between them. First, it is very complex. Second, it strictly follows my prompt. This is exactly what the Bindweave model focuses on solving, the problem of complex actions and strong interaction. Of course, Qijai's current level of reproduction for this model is not yet particularly high. Therefore, the overall workflow presentation and the genuine official capability of Bindweave that we see still have some gap. Nevertheless, the improvement in the model's effect is quite prominent. Everyone can try it out themselves, okay. That is all for today. Follow me to become someone who understands AI.